like holes in the planet.
But yeah, we just strip see Dark Cherubimon.
He's just straight up in the intro.
Yeah, he's just straight up in there, the book. Yeah, he's in the book,
Oh, right, they run into Bokomon and Namon.
Yeah, in episode one, they ran into Bokomon and Namon, and it's like, of course,
Namon Namon is far less annoying in the original sub, in the original dialogue.
Yeah, Bokomon's whole thing is he is like a well-learned book Digimon who has book, and he looks up things in book. And Namon's really useful to have because he's an annoying side character that probably won't do anything.
More so in the dub, as far as I can tell. In the sub, he just seems to follow around and repeat whatever Bokomon says, but otherwise he seems like inoffensive.
So far inoffensive, but also I will wait for him to prove his worth. Jeff, so it's a different environment, basically. Oh yeah, that's cool. Actually didn't like, yeah, alright. Oh man. Man, all I really remember of Namon is, like, you remember Digimon Rumble Arena 2?
Yeah, yeah, kinda. I didn't play 2 nearly as much as the first one.
Yeah, he got to 2 at some point, and he's, like, a weird, like, unlockable extra character. And his whole fighting style is he doesn't evolve, and he just, like, farts and, like, throws crap at you, and he slips on banana peels. Thinking back, it probably is banana peels. I think as a kid, I thought he shot, like, a giant, like, clipped toenail at you or something, because it was really hard to tell. But the move was called Happy Accident, so that makes more sense. Oh, we're getting to the weird nostalgia crap now. Oh, man. But yeah, effing, like, people are just exploring around. It's like, yeah, new digital world. Hey, what happens if we give these things chocolate? Oh god, they hate us.
Yeah, if you give a Pokemon a piece of chocolate, it's gonna want more.
Yeah, Digimon Elements, the series was different. Okay, yeah. But yeah, JP, sorry, like, friend Junpei just gives these things chocolate, and they're like, well, yeah, give us more, and he doesn't have more. It's like, they are in training, so we could probably fight one, but there's a lot of them. So yeah, this becomes a problem.
Yeah, there's a lot of them, and they just, like, start biting you, and it's like, oh, jeez.
Oh no, Digital World wants us dead. Like, but yeah, we start to sort of, like, figure out what everyone's, like, whole deal is, because it's like, alright, Koji's a lone wolf, effing Takuya is, like, protagonist shonen boy. Junpei is just a, like, selfish dick idiot.
Yeah,
Junpei,
he's not great.
Just sucks. And friggin', like, what was his name? Like, Tommy or whatever, whatever the crap.
Tomoki.
Tomoki, yeah. Tomoki's just TK 1.5 or whatever. I won't say 2.0, we have 2.0. We have TK 2.0 at home. And Izumi's whole, like, character trait is that she's, like, girl and she says calzone or whatever.
Izumi knows Italian and she likes to bring it up. She knows some Italian.
They beat evil Digimon and she's like, oh yeah, calzone, that's a spicy meatball. That's her contribution.
I actually looked up what it was she said, but I already forgot what it meant. I think it was just an expression of, like, being impressed or whatever.
I ironically don't even remember.
Yeah, it's whatever. That's her trait. She speaks Italian sometimes.
She is situationally Italian.
I mean, so the blonde hair, like, you know, how, like,
Yeah, she's probably a foreigner, I get you.
Yeah. Or at least half. She's, like, like half something else.
Yeah, it, like, makes sense. I'd believe it. But, yeah, like, effing Junpei goes missing, and everyone's like, all right, let's, like, try and find Junpei. He's gotta be somewhere. And, like, they have, like, Takuya and Izumi just fall down a pit, and she has a weird, like, flirt moment with him.
Yeah, they're like holding each other or something, because they were trying to like they're probably just grabbing onto whatever was closest in an attempt to not fall.
Yeah, and she gets all embarrassed, and it's like, yeah, you have a cute little moment where he's like, oh yeah, it's not my fault or whatever, Baka. You know, he's like, yeah, you should be more careful. You're older than me and or whatever, and she's like, I'm just 12, and I'm like, oh no. Oh no!
Yeah, there's like a whole thing where it's like, oh, how old are you? I'm this old. It's like, oh, a month. Oh, I'm like, oh, only a few months older than you. But I am older than you, so ha. And it's like, okay.
This character is gonna become Kazemon. Oh no.
Yeah.
Oh no. That's the thing, it's like, somehow them, like, fusing into Digimon form so far has been less weird than it was in, like, the sub of Tamers. They've, like, pulled it back a bit, and that's fine.
Yeah. At least we don't see the characters, like, naked but censored.
Yeah, yeah, it's like, you get the, like, whole, like, you know, just whatever spirit form thing for the transformation, and then it's like, done, you're a Digimon now.
Yeah, whenever they transform, they just turn into like a black silhouette.
Yeah, yeah, it's like way more tactful. Yes, so everyone's like, hey, we gotta save like Tomoki and Junpei. And meanwhile, like, aged them up. Yeah, I think the dub's like, our characters are in every... I think the dub, like, aged them up, the characters in every series. Okay, yeah, that makes a lot of sense, honestly.
Yeah. Also, Junpei has, like, an absurd amount of chocolate on him.
Oh, yeah, like, just actually absurd.
The Pokemon are attacking him, and it's falling out of him like a pinata. It's like, oh, because he's the fat kid. He's got to have a lot of chocolate.
If you're the fat one, but you're also, like, a jerk, does that stop you from being as much of a stereotype? Does that even remotely counteract the trope?
No. You can be a crappy person and have any kind of body.
Yeah, that's true. That's pretty true.
No excuse for him being a jerk.
I was referring more to the chocolate trope of just, oh, fat people always got the food on them, but alright.
Oh, I don't know, man.
No, man.
I mean, I love chocolate. Who doesn't love chocolate?
Yeah. Chocolate's good, man. I got like a bag of it next to me right now.
It's kind of goofy that he has so much of it, but...
It's more than I have in my literal bag.
Yeah. Junpei has chocolate in, like, hammer space.
Oh god, I just realized something. Alright, hear me out. Well, if Junpei is not fat, he just has a really big, like, bag of chocolate in his jumpsuit.
I'm pretty sure he's actually just like a fat kid.
like well, for the course of the series, we see him just gradually start to thin out, and then, like, he runs out of chocolate and he just looks like a normal guy. And he's like, damn it, how am I gonna get more chocolate now? I used it all up. He like just opens up the like jumpsuit, he's like ripped. He's got like a six pack.
That would be funny, but like his facial structure and like his arms don't really match it.
Oh man. It would be really hilarious. I want someone to do that.
Yeah. The problem is that, like, you can tell from his face that he's clearly just fat.
Yeah. Never forget, there's just, like, an effing, like, friggin' giant, orally muscular, crazy-looking dude in friggin', like, Promare. And it is just revealed he is a very short man in a robot suit with a really huge head. So weirder things have happened.
Ah, MODOK.
He's just a really short dude with an absurdly, like, big, friggin', like, crazy anime villain face. I felt like if I showed you this character design, it would not make any more sense than it does in the movie.
I don't know.
Oh, man. But yeah, eventually the friggin' Pagumon just start getting annoyed with him, and they somehow evolve together into a Raremon.
Actually,
like,
no.
Yeah, alright.
Actually, no, it's just one of them.
Oh, is it just... Yeah.
One of the Pagumon gets mad after Koji, like, grabs a steel pipe and, like, starts beating on them.
Yeah, alright, that's even weirder then, because it's like, it goes from in training to champion,
up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what, honestly, I'm fine with them skipping a stage. That's fair enough.
It's fine, he needed something comparable to fight, even though Raremon is probably one of the weakest champions around.
Yeah, you'd be surprised.
I mean, he's like a filth Digimon, so he's like Numamon tier.
Yeah, like, I fought that thing in Digimon World 2, and Buffalo Breath is a bitch. Effing, like, just for encounter infusion on your... counter confusion on your Digimon, and now suddenly it just attacks your other party members. It is a pain to deal with. Raremon can be really dangerous.
Outside of video game mechanics, Raremon is just, it's another filth Digimon.
Yeah. I'd believe he's stronger than, like, you know, like, Numamon at least.
Yeah.
Because I look at him.
Raremon's probably, like, Sukumon level.
He's probably, I'd imagine Raremon's, like, a proper champion for the most part. Yeah, I'd imagine.
But yeah, so yeah, at some point Koji showed up and he pulled a metal pipe out of the ground and he starts whipping Pagumon with it.
Can we just talk a second about how Koji can, like, actually fight, like, without a Digimon partner?
Yes, in fact, my thought was, why doesn't he carry a weapon? Like, why doesn't he keep the pipe?
Yeah, that'd be really useful, actually.
It would be very useful, like, even if it's just to fend off, like, small Digimon that come after them, or, like, resist a slight, like, a rookie for a minute, like...
Yeah, because we do learn this episode that, like, going into your spirit form does use, like, energy. Like, there's a limit to, like, you know, how many times you can do it, and it has to, like, recharge.
Yeah, because Takuya is just like, let me transform again, and he just can't get it to do it.
Yeah, he's like, let me transform, and the Digivice is like, no. And he forces it to happen so he can, like, save friggin' Takuya from... Sorry, not Takuya, so he can save Koji from this Raremon that's, like, vomiting acid. And he, like, stops one of the shots from hitting him, and then he just reverts back. And the Digivice is like, okay, you happy now?
But yeah, Koji finds the Spirit of Light and turns into Wolfmon, or Lobomon, depending on what you want to call him.
I prefer Wolfmon. Wolfmon's fine.
Yeah. And he beats the rare Mon.
I honestly do really like this sequence a lot. Because it's like, they're just in this weird little, like, you know, like, dome underground, and like, Raremon's just blasting acid everywhere. So it's like, all the places where he shoots the acid, it's like, you're seeing the light beam in from outside, and like, Koji goes down the ride hole to find the spirit, and you see all the beams of light just sort of converge on the hole as he gets the thing. Like, it's really cool.
Yeah, it's a pretty cool sequence.
Yeah, he, like, comes up, he has the cool, like, scarf and everything.
Yeah, Lobomon has cool, like, light, like, literal lightsabers.
Yeah, he uses the energy swords. It's like, friggin', like, it feels like all of Lobomon's forms just get all the good stuff. Because he's got, like, the energy swords, he has, like, the scarf, he's got, like, a friggin', like, gun on his arm.
And he looks like a robot.
Yeah, like, I feel like Lobomon's design is just a winner overall, really.
Yeah, he's one of my favorites of the kids.
Yeah, and, like, up to Magna Garurumon, all those other forms look really cool as well. Friggin' Beowulf Thon's pretty neat. Friggin' Kendo Garurumon. Yeah, it's another thing. I probably should have mentioned that, because I think I kind of, like, referred to this in a different part or whatever. But yeah, just the dub changed their Beast Spirit forms names to, like, friggin', like, Burning Greymon, Kendo Garurumon. And guess what? That causes a lot of problems for the card game.
Does it?
Yeah, because now every single, like, English card that mentions Greymon has to actively have text saying, like, a card with Greymon in its name, excluding Burning Greymon and, like, friggin' Doru Greymon and stuff. And it's just, like, a big list of, like, something like 3 or 4 different things that they specifically have to, like, just rule out every time, like, just something targets a Greymon form specifically. And, like, same for Garurumon, but honestly, like, not as bad realistically.
Yeah.
There's not as many Garurumon knockoffs.
Yeah, there's way more Greymons.
Oh man, not as many, like, Garurumon name changes. That's another thing. Yeah, I don't know if you, like, you probably, like, can't hear or whatever, but yeah, friggin', like, Sistermon Seal finally got into the card game. Like, the actual Sistermon Seal, like, in the original, like, you know, Japanese and stuff.
Hmm.
So yeah, Sistermon Seal is just, like, super canon now.
Yeah, alright.
Yeah, I'm up for it, yeah. But yeah, cool fight with, like, friggin' Wolfmon.
Yeah, he, like, beats...
Yeah.
He beats Raremon. Did he use the code to restore anything? I don't remember.
I don't think he used the code to restore anything, but he definitely scanned the code.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I don't think Raremon ate any, like, data. He just used the attack, so I don't know if it will have worked. Yeah.
Yeah. Also, Koji helps, but he's not really interested in hanging out with everybody else.
Yeah, he's gotta be a lone wolf, get it?
Wow.
It's such an obvious joke, but I ironically think that's what they're going for. Like, legit, I think that's the thing.
Nah. Adventure 1 had a fire main character and a loner, like, wolf-themed side character.
Yeah, exactly, and they're doing it again. Just the friggin' rival character has to have a wolf, and then they gotta be a lone wolf, unless their partner is a bug or a fox.
Yeah.
Oh man. But yeah, overall, like, just solid episode. Like, takes a bit to get to the thing, but yeah, this is a fun time.
Yeah. Frontier starts off and it's fine.
Yeah, it's fine, you know. Like, it's pretty cool. There's cool, like, evolutions and reveals and stuff, you know. Like, I know what these forms look like, and, like, just from what I've seen, they look pretty cool for the most part. And I'm excited to see them do really cool things.
Yeah.
Except for Kazemon. Kazemon's going to get so just... Like, I remember there specifically being, like, a scene, like, later on, where everyone has to, like, destroy a floating, like, crystal or something. And it's just every character just transforms and does a cool attack and breaks it in one. And then, like... Friggin' Kazemon does the thing and, like, attacks the crystal and it doesn't work because she's too weak and pathetic. And she's the only one, specifically, that has to go beast form to break the thing. Because Kazemon is just way weaker than everyone else for no reason.
I think we've established that the Digimon writers aren't great at writing female characters.
So far, not really. I feel like Rui's, like, Rui and Rika are, like, the exceptions so far. Like, I'll go past the Rui. She's a bit, like, boring, but yeah, she's fine.
Of course there are exceptions, but, like...
Yeah, it's...
The movies make me go, yikes.
The movies are yikes, and then also, like, friggin'... Well, honestly, think about, Adventure and O2 had pretty good female casts. Yeah, like, Mimi's a bit annoying, but, you know, at least she has a personality.
I mostly mean when we get to, like, Try and Kizuna.
Oh, yeah, 100%. Well, I'm more fine with Kizuna, yeah.
I mean, Kizuna's a better movie. Kizuna's a better movie overall, and Minowa's probably a better character overall than...
I feel like Minowa honestly is a pretty good villain.
Yeah, better than What's-Her-Face, who got killed.
Yeah.
Hopefully.
Hopefully, God, jeez. Try is like the... Watch our Try, like, friggin' episodes. Try is insane, what the heck?
Yeah, we do this every so often where we just, it's like, oh yeah, Try, remember Try? And it's like,
Say, Digimon does pretty decent with female characters, but they're definitely some bad ones. Oh yeah. There's definitely some low points.
Well, it's like characters in Try, it's like, oh yeah, everything, like... Oh yeah, Kari was like, I don't know, she's fine originally, and like, oh, Ty might be dead, we don't know, but she breaks down to the point where, what is it, freaking Ophanimon, like, goes corrupt and fuses with Nikumon or some crap?
Yeah, just straight up, and there come, like, the destroyer of worlds.
All because Kari just, like, kind of snapped at the slightest, like, possible bad thing, and it's like, holy crap.
That's the thing, Ordinemon in, like, friggin' the card game, like, the final boss of Try is a really cool card, is, like, really cool mechanics. It's like, the whole thing is like, oh, if you have one security or less and you're about to lose, then you can, like, play a thing and it's a big, crazy, stupid comeback. But it's like, I hate that, like, friggin' Digimon so much because its design is terrible and how it happens is the dumbest.
Yeah.
It's like...
Yeah, and I've vented my frustrations with Kizuna, which, like I said, isn't actually bad. It's just... There's entire concepts about, like, the Digidestined and their partners that I hate.
Friggin' Eosmon all the way, man. Eosmon's the best. Eosmon... Yeah, the big, like, friggin', like, moth thing that did, like, friggin' barriers, yeah.
Oh, the, what's it called?
Yeah, Morphomon's whole evolution. Yeah, Morphomon,
okay, yeah.
Where it's like, you sub the barriers and you just, like, just form them in, like, the middle of an opponent's weapon and just break it apart.
Yeah, yeah.
And it's like, yeah, that's pretty good.
Yeah. So, yeah, I hate a lot of stuff about Try, and, like, it's just depressing and bad, and the... And then, like, Kizan is good except for the parts that I hate where it's like, these children were chosen along with 8 Digimon who are destined to be erased forever. Because, I don't know, screw you.
Yeah, you just use all the power to Digivolve them, and it's like, I guess that power has to come from somewhere, even though the Dream World is a thing.
What's that? You formed the lifetime bond with your partner that we set up to happen, and now we're going to take them away from you. And not only take them away from you, but erase them from existence. I guess you just have to live with that.
Yeah, just look, like, for in, like, if anyone's, like, curious, just watch the big lore dump episode I did. Friggin', like, Yggdrasil's a dick.
Yeah, Yggdrasil's the worst.
Yeah, Yggdrasil and, like, homeostasis are behind all this crap, and every decision they make is, like, friggin', like, understandable, but terrible. And even that's, like, reaching.
Are we getting a movie that takes place after Kizuna? I feel like that was something that was announced.
Maybe. I know we're getting, like, a Tamers, like, sequel, reboot, something like that.
I want there to be a sequel to Kizuna, and it's all the younger members of the cast being like, okay, this is some bullcrap. We gotta fight this somehow.
Yeah, the erasing stuff is overkill. Oh yeah, that's fair.
It's ridiculous. Like, it's worse for the Digimon who didn't do anything. They were selected by the will of the digital world to die.
Nah, we're getting O2 movie. Honestly, I'm fine with that. Like, O2 had some good ideas. It's yeah, put good writers in charge. Yeah, there's, like, stuff to work with.
So it is a sequel to Kizuna, because 02 takes place in the same universe.
Yeah, I guess it is. Yeah.
You can't just detach it from that plot.
Yo, real talk, was the Tamer sequel we were getting, like, was that the weird, like, cancel culture play that guy did? The writer did, like, on stage for, like, the 20th anniversary? Where it's just an entire thing about how the world is going to, like, crap and everything's terrible, and the big villain's, like, just method of gaining power is cancel culture. And then the guy came out and had a bunch of really bad takes about COVID.
I try to separate the artist from his work.
Listen, like, anyone out there, if anyone knows where to actually find that reading, I want to watch it. I want to see the train wreck. I've heard people talk about it. I legitimately cannot find it. It's crazy. It's been, like, scrubbed from the internet.
Tamer sequels dropped by Toei? Nah, whatever. As much as I love Tamers, I would prefer that to them pulling a try... Or making stupid decisions with the plot like Kizuna.
Man, I really hope the cancel culture rant didn't make them drop it.
I don't know. I
agree with the cancel culture part at least. Oh, man. cancel culture, or as it was known before the internet age, just like having like problems with something.
Yeah. Okay, so, are we ready to move on to
Ghost Gate? Alright, okay. Yeah, let's move on.
I need a minute to use the restroom, so...
Alright, I will get Ghost Game loaded up before I, like, just alienate my entire audience.
Yeah, I'll be back, just talk about whatever, I guess.
Oh, so cancel culture, right?